Back to my channel. So today I'll be showing you guys how to cut a flounce, and this is just going to be a very quick tutorial. So basically what you're going to do is get your fabric that you're using to cut it. So you see my fabric is this way. So you're going to get this like square shaped fabric, depending on how much flounce you need or the size. So it depends on you. So you see mine, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to fold it into two, because what I'm cutting here is the smaller flounce. So fold it into two, and then you're going to now fold it into four. Iron it so that you can get, iron the corners so that you can get that sharp. It will help you divide the fabric into four shapes, right? So what I'm going to do now, I've already ironed mine, but there are other lines on this here. But so I'm just going to show you guys. So I'm going to open it up. This is my center mark here. So I'm going to mark the line to divide the fabric into four. So guys, as you can see, I've marked the lines right from the ironing that I did. So I followed the tracing of that line. So now you see my fabric is divided into four, and then I have my center part here. This is the center part. If I fold this now, you find that this is the center part of this fabric here. So this part here is the center of the fabric if it's folded into four. So this center part, I'm going to just, from this center part here, I'm just going to mark 2 inches, right? It depends on you, whatever you want to use, 2 inches, 3 inches, it's still the same. So I'm just going to use 2 inches at the center here. And before you start doing this, just mark 2 inches all the way around, like how you normally do with compass, and just trace like 2 inches round, right? So from this center now, I'm just going to be marking 2 inches away, 2 inches away, until I make a circle. I know you might be wondering how much of this, how I got the length of this folded fabric. As you can see, I've marked my circle, right? But I wanted to tell you guys, I know you might be wondering how I got the length of this circle here, how the length of the fabric I'm using to fold this. All you have to, like when I was cutting out this square, what I use is basically try to, if it's 2 inches that you're going to use to mark that circle that I just marked in the center, right? Or if it's 3 inches, just add that 3 inches or 2 inches, whatever you decide to make that initial circle. That initial circle doesn't matter what you use. You can use one, you can use two. It's just for you to get a starting point. So after that, you're going to add the length of the flounce you're using. So for me, I'm going to be using about 4.5. That's including my seam allowance of folding the flounce. So 4.5, I made sure that the 4.5 would, I need two times of that. So I made sure that the 4.5 two times. So let's say I mark my 2 inches, right? After that 2 inches, I have another 4.5, right? And then another 4.5 can also fit. So that's how I determine the length I'm using here. Just make sure that whatever you want, if you're working with a larger flounce or you want a bigger portion, just make sure that when you fold your fabric, two times of that or three times of that, it can go round. Like after the initial 2 inches or whatever you're using, make sure that your flounce can go several times on that length on each side, right? So after that 2 inches on this side is also the same thing. So it's left for you to determine it using this method. So guys, the next thing you're going to do now, when I've opened it up again, so what you're going to do now is you're going to go, you see this is one compartment, one angle here, one angle here. Choose any compartment of your choice, right? Any part of this of your choice. And then you're going to mark about 1 inch on one here. You see, I've marked 1 inch here. And then this one, the next one, so if you choose to mark 1 inch from the line, that's 1 inch from this line that is dividing this here. I've marked it. And then the next one that is following it now, facing this way, after your 1 inch, the next one following it, you're going to figure out halfway through that one. So I have 3 inches here. Halfway through that will be 1.5 here. So on that line is where you're going to mark the length you're using. So like I said, mine is 4.5. So I'm going to mark my 4.5 on that line. So this line here, my 4.5 is here. Right, so from this point now, you're going to take this, your 1 inch now, you're going to use it to connect this here. So you see, so that's how you blend in your line, so you can curve it more if you want. So you see, this is how you blend in the line. So now you've cut out how you're going to start going round and round. So from here now, you're going to just mark 4.5. And then you're going to keep going 4.5. If you're using the same length all the way around, then just use that same measurement all the way. So you're going to keep marking from this your circle will be your landmark. You're going to keep marking that's 4.5 or whatever length you're using. But let's say you want to do the one like the one that increases as you go. So it depends on you. Maybe from this point now you make it 5 inches and then you keep going 6 and then you go around, just you increase it as you go. If you want that spiral one that has like increase with the length. But for me, mine is going to be the same length all the way. So all I have to do is just put my tape here on this line here and just measure my 4.5 all the way around. So guys, you see, I've gotten back to this point where I started. So now my measurement is going to come from my next line. So from here, I'm going to mark my 4.5 on whatever length you're using. So you see, I'm still marking the same 4.5 here. So now this is my new line now. I'm going into my second line, you see, and I'm using this as my line instead of the one at the center. So you see, this is the way I've entered the second line. So now it's going to spiral all the way. So guys, as you can see, I've gone ahead and cut this out. I've gone ahead and marked out every line that I need. So you see how the line goes here. So it started from the center and then we made the way into the next first line and then we went round and then we entered the next line, you see, and then that's how we went all over again and came back here. So at this point here now, this is where the last point where this 4.5 inches can fit in. This is the last point where the 4.5 can fit in, because if I keep going, like I said, it can only go 3 times. So if you see, my 4.5 cannot go further anymore. So that means I have to stop at this point here. So you see, my 4.5 was fitting in all the way coming this way. And then when I got to this point, it can't fit in anymore. This is the last point where it's going to fit in. So this is where I'm going to stop. As you can see, I've marked a straight line here to show that I have stopped here. Or if you want, you can give it like a tail and just give it like a slanted shape. Instead of going straight this way, you can just go this way, right? And then from this point now, you start cutting it out. So all I have to do now is to take my scissors and then I'm going to start from this point here and cut open. So I'm going to cut this here. Cut here. So now you see, I've entered the line. So I've cut this open. I'm going to go this way and cut all the way around. So guys, as you can see, I've started cutting it. You see where I am now. So I'm still going round. I'll cut out all this way. So guys, as you can see, I've cut out the excess at the edges now, right? So this is what I cut out. This I'm going to dispose, right? So now I'm going to start cutting into my flounce. So to cut into my flounce, I'm going to start with this line and then I'll go in. All I just did now was to cut off all the excess around, right? And then now I'm going to just start in here and then go in and then keep going. Guys, as you can see, I'm still cutting. You see why I said the one at the center doesn't matter if you use 1 inch or 2 inch, because at the end of the day, you're still going to cut this out and throw it away. So guys, you see my flounce now. So the one at the center, that 2 inches I marked, I've taken it out. So now this is my flounce. If I open it up, so you see, this is what it looks like all the way. So now what I have to do is to cut this same thing on a lining. And then when I cut it on a lining, all I have to do is to join the end here, join the end all the way around. So it's normally better to use lining to fold the end, because this is cut like a circle. So if you try to use to fold the end this way, like how you normally fold the end of your clothes, it will look rough. So it's better when you finish cutting it, you cut out the lining for it and then you join it at the bottom part and then attach the top part to the body of whatever you're working with. The bigger pleats, the bigger flounce are normally used like with pleating. And then these smaller ones, they are normally used like ruffles attached to clothes. So that's basically it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Bye.